Hi.
In this video, let us try to understand this problem called robot bounded in a circle and try to come up with a solution for this. This is more of a math problem. You are given with a robot which is initially at 0,0 position of a coordinate system facing north direction. Robot can perform either of these three instructions. G means go straight by 1 unit, L means turn left by 90 degrees, R means turn right by 90 degrees. The input is given in the form of a string which is formed with the above allowed three instructions. You need to return true if by performing the given set of instructions any number of times, like once, twice, 5 times, 15 times, 100 times. After performing those instructions, are you going to end up being in a cycle or not? If you're not going to be inside a cycle, just return false. Let us try to understand the problem statement by looking at some examples. So here the instruction set is G, G, L, L, G, G. Initially I am at 0,0 position. So let me write it here maybe. So 0,0 and I'll be facing in north direction. Now after executing this 0, like G, so from here I have to move in this direction by one position, like 1 unit. That means I'll be going to 0,1 here. And I got another G, and in the same direction I have to make a move by 1 unit again. So I'll be going from here to here again. So that means it is 0,2. And from here I got a L. That means I just need to turn left by 90 degrees. That means from north direction I'll turn left by 90 degrees, which is west. And again I got L. That means I have to change my direction again by 90 degrees to left. So it'll be here towards south direction. Then I got G, that means I have to make a move now by 1 unit. So in this south direction, I have to make a move like here. That means I'll come to, it is 0,1. Now I got another G, so I have to make another move in the same direction here. So I'll be reaching the same point, 0,0. So where I started, I ended up being at the same position, like 0,0 to 0,0. So that is a cycle. So that means just return true. If you take a look at next example, like G and G. So initially I am at 0,0. So 0,0 north direction. Now I am starting from here. G means I have to make a move in the north direction by 1 unit here. So I'll be reaching 0,1. There is another G. That means in the same direction, I have to make a move again, like by 1 unit. So it is 0,2. So I started from 0,0 and I ended up being at 0,2 after executing this instruction set. If I execute the same instruction set again, like GG, I'll move further away from this point. Like from my 0,0, I'll move further away. Like I'll go to 0,4 here after this one. If I execute it again, then I'll be going to 0,6. I'll keep going like 0, infinity. So I'll never come back to my initial position or one of these positions. That means, yeah, there is no possibility for a cycle here. So just return false. Let's check this 0, L. So initially I'm at 0,0. I need to execute this G statement, that is move by 1 unit in the north direction. So I'll end up being at 0,1 and I'll be facing north direction only, like 0,0. North direction. Then I got a L, which means I just need to turn left. That means instead of north facing, I'll be facing towards the west direction. So I still being at 0,1, but I'll be looking at west direction. Now if you ask me to execute this instruction again, G,L, so I'll move from here to here. That is -1,1. So this point, if I execute the same instruction set again, 0,G,L, then I'll be going to this one and I'll be facing towards this east direction. So earlier I was facing west, now I'll be facing towards the east direction. So it'll be -1,0. Now if I execute this again, G,L, so I'll be going towards my initial position, 0,0, and I'll be facing north direction. That means here 0,0. So I ended up being at the same position again after executing this each exit for 4 times. So that means there is a cycle, return true. So let us try to generalize this problem for all possible combinations. So assume we are given with some instruction set like I1, I2, I3 till IN. So this can be of any length. Assuming this is a black box, and initially assume we are at some position like AB. In the problem, we are given this as 0, 0, and we are facing in the direction of north. Now, after executing this instruction set, I'll be at some position called XY, and for the direction there are four possibilities like north, east, west, south, north, east, west, south, any of these four possibilities. So AB, north to XY, and any of these directions. So just to generalize, from here to here we can have multiple combinations. Let's list them down here. So first thing is, like, I ended up being at the same position, like my A comma B is equal to X comma Y. That means I started at 0, 0, and I might have taken some steps, and then I ended up being at the same position. That means clearly there is a cycle, so just return true. So irrespective of the direction, we are ended up being at the same position, so just return true. And next thing is, my A comma B is not equal to X comma Y, but from north I reach the same direction, like north through north. So from somewhere like here, I ended up being here, and I was facing till this here, and I'll be facing in the same direction, north through north. So that means from here to here I have gone. And if I execute the same again, like same instruction set again, I'll move further away from here to here. I will be still facing in the north direction. And again, yeah, same north direction. So I'll be moving further away from my initial position. So there is no possibility for meeting at the same point, or there is a cycle. So just return false from this case. And there is another possibility, like A comma B is not equal to X comma Y, but from north I end up being at other directions like east, west, or south. So from here, let's assume now we move to some position like this, but I'm facing in the east direction, so here to here, and in a different direction. Now if I execute the same instruction set again, so I'll be moving somewhere here, like if the direction is here, we are going here, means yeah, if the direction is here, we'll be moving somewhere towards maybe something like this, and I'll be facing towards the south direction here. And if I execute the instruction set again, like this I1 to IN, so I'll be moving somewhere from here to here, and I'll be looking at like west position, like west direction. And if I execute the instruction set again, like fourth time, so I ended up being at the same position, like initial position, and I'll be looking at north direction. So that means, so if my initial direction and end direction are not same, then after executing this instruction set for four times, I'll be reaching the same initial positions. So definitely there'll be a cycle here. So this statement is true for other directions also, like north through west or north through south. So if you look at, or if you take care of these four or these three conditions, then there'll be enough to write a program, and they'll definitely yield a solution for us. Before start writing the program, let us try to understand one thing. So assume we are at some position like 0, 0 initially. So if I move in north direction, so I'll be going to 0, 1, and if I move in east direction, I'll be going to 1, 0, and in south direction it's going to be 0, -1, and in the west direction it's going to be -1, 0. If I write this in terms of A comma B, then this is going to be A comma B plus 1, and this is going to be A plus 1 comma B, and this is going to be A comma B minus 1, and this is going to be A minus 1 comma B. So when writing the program, just keep this in mind. Let's start writing the program. So let me define two variables, like my initial points 0, b equal 0, and since initial direction is north, so let me define that. So assuming 0 as north, so let me define that. So 0 is my north, one is my east, two is my south, and three is my west. Now I need to define something like my directions. So let me copy that. So this says like, yeah, if I'm at some direction and I'm making a move in the direction, means like if I'm facing towards the east direction, which is going to be my first index position, I just need to change my B value, not the A value. So A will remain same. It's just that, yeah, for B we'll add 1. That means from 0, 0, if I'm moving in the direction of east, I'll be going to 0, 1, because I just added this 0 to 1. Now let's go through each and every instruction set. For I equal 0, I less than instructions dot length I plus plus. Let's try to store the char into a variable, instructions dot char at of I. Now there are three possibilities for this character. So if my character is G, and to do something, and if my character is L, I will do something else, and if my character is R, I will do something else. So let's try to write the easy things first. So if my character is R, I just need to turn right by 90 degrees. That means if I'm in the direction of north, I need to go to east. So how I can go to east? I just need to add 1. Like from 0, if I go to east, like north through east, I just need to increment my direction value. That means direction equal to direction plus 1. But there is a condition that from west, if I turn right, I need to go to north. That means from 3, if I add 1, I'll get 4. So in that case, I just need to take a modulus. So direction plus 1 percentile by 4. So this will give me my right direction. Similarly for left, if I'm going from east, like turn left by 90 degrees, I just need to decrement my direction by 0. So direction equal to direction minus 1. And if you look at this 0, like north position, from here, if you turn left, I need to go to west position, but I'll be getting minus 1. So there is a special condition that if direction is 0, just assign 3 to it, else direction minus 1. And in case of G, I need to make a move by looking at these values. So my A is going to be directions of like whatever is my current direction, which is stored in direction, that dir variable. And to A, I need to consider the first value. So I just need to take this 0. I just need to add this to A. That means A equal to A plus this one. Similarly, for B, it's going to be B equal to B plus second element. I think that's it, yeah. Now let's look at the all possibilities. Like if my initial position and end position both are same, like A equal to equal 0 and B equal to equal 0, then I just need to return true. If that is not the case and my direction is same as my initial direction, then it's going to be diverging, so return false. This is my second possibility. Otherwise, just return true. If directions are different, we are going to end up being at the same position after 4 times. So let's try to run the code for input. And if you take another example, maybe GG and VGL. Yeah. So this is how the code looks like. Thank you for watching this video. Please do like or share this. For more such videos, please do subscribe to this channel. If you have any suggestions or comments, please write them here. Thank you.